Welcome back to the Britannia Coin Company. We're a coin dealer based in Royal Wootton Bassett in the UK. Can you believe that another month has passed us and we've had a whole bunch of new coins come out, and my friend here has returned from the Royal Mint to give us some news about the new Harry Potter coins coming out this year too. So let's have a look at it then. First up, the Harry Potter coins that are due out before the end of the year. With four designs over 32 coins, including a range of 50p coins, we got a bit of tantalising news that on Thursday the 8th of September at 7pm, the Royal Mint will be doing a live streamed event from the Royal Mint Experience to reveal the four designs which we are going to be getting. Whether we find out if this highly anticipated release will enter circulation, who knows, but it's definitely a date to put in your diary. I wish you'd just tell me if they're going to circulation. We're all so excited about it. This month started with the release of the penultimate Winnie the Pooh 50 pence coin. The design by the Walt Disney Company features Kanga and Roo. The previous coins in the set include Winnie the Pooh, Christopher Robin, Piglet, Winnie the Pooh and Friends, Owl, Tigger and Eeyore. They have been released three a year since 2020. It's amazing how time flies with the end of this series of coins already upon us. The coin was released in base metal brilliant uncirculated, or BU standard, which has an unlimited run up to demand. There were also 12,500 colorized versions of the design in base metal, 6,000 silver proofs and 150 gold proofs as well. This month also saw the end of the Queen's Reign Collection, a series of three £5 coins. The latest one commemorates her time as head of the Commonwealth. The design features the flags of the Commonwealth with her personal flag at the centre, and below that her signature, which was the first time in this series the Queen's signature appeared on coinage. This series celebrated three important areas of the Queen's 70-year reign. The first coin commemorated the honour and investiture system, the second one celebrated her charitable work, and as I said, the final coin commemorates her time as the head of the Commonwealth. It was designed by PJ Lynch, who was also behind 2021's Britannia's. The coin was released in an unlimited run subject to demand with the base metal BU coins. There were 4,000 silver proofs, 1,500 silver piafuds, which are coins that are double the thickness of a standard silver proof. There were 500 1/4 ounce gold proofs and 250 gold proofs. This month also saw the end of another popular series with the release of the last Winnie the Pooh 50p coin. This being the second Winnie the Pooh and Friends coin, as there was one last year, albeit with a different design. The ninth and final coin to be released over the last 3 years sports a design featuring Winnie the Pooh, Piglet, Eeyore and Tigger, who have all featured on their own individual coins in previous releases. This again had an unlimited run to demand for the base metal BU versions. There were 12,500 colorized versions, 6,000 silver proofs and 150 gold proofs available to purchase. This coin also became the latest Royal Mint Experience Strike Your Own Coin 2. At the Royal Mint headquarters in Llantrisant, South Wales, they run tours of the Royal Mint and you have the opportunity to strike your own coin as part of that tour. And the coin you can get changes periodically. We're not exactly sure how long this one's going to run for, although the Royal Mint did confirm it was going to run until the end of autumn. Although not in August, we did have one more coin that got released on the 1st of September. It was the latest installment in the Royal Tudor Beast series. We're still waiting for our coins to arrive, but we're expecting them very, very soon. The Yale of Beaufort was the latest release. In the past, it was included in a previous collection of Mighty Beasts, the Queen Beast series, which ran for 5 years before being concluded in 2021. These were designed by Jodie Clark, the same designer that created the fifth and current portrait of the Queen on coins. The Royal Tudor Beast collection is the successor to the highly successful Queen Beast series. previously having had the Seymour Panther and the Lion of England on their own coins. Each of the coins that will feature in this set have statues lining the moat bridge of Hampton Court Palace, which were installed to promote the legitimacy of King Henry VIII's reign and highlight the strength of the Tudor dynasty. Do you know what a Yale is? The Yale is a mythological creature, sometimes referred to as a centaurus. It's commonly a goat or antelope-like creature with the tusks of a boar and horns which can swivel in any direction. They were first written about by Pliny the Elder, who wrote at least 75 books, with Historia Naturalis being the largest single work to have survived from the Roman Empire. The book was a 37-volume collection documenting basically everything the Romans knew about the natural world. The Yale entered the British royal family's heraldry through Henry VII, whose mother was of the Beaufort family, which had used the creature as their heraldic emblem. So, when King Henry VII slayed Richard III in battle and proclaimed himself king, the Yale came along with him. The Royal Tudor Beasts version of the Yale of Beaufort was released with an unlimited run of base metal BU coins, which again will be minted to demand. There were 5,000 1-ounce silver proofs, 1,250 2-ounce silver proofs, 300 5-ounce silver proofs, 100 10-ounce silver proofs, and 10 1-kilogram silver proofs. There were also 500 2-coin sets which feature a 1-ounce silver proof and a 1-ounce silver coin with a frosted reverse. The gold range consists of 750 quarter-ounce gold proofs, 400 1-ounce gold proofs, 100 2-ounce gold proofs, and 50 5-ounce gold proofs. In addition, there is a range of silver, gold, and platinum bullion versions of this coin as well. This coin series has been created by David Lawrence, someone who has had amazing success in designing coins over the years, with a range of £5 coins to commemorate the centenary of the First World War, the Agatha Christie £2 coin, William Wordsworth £5 coin, and that's just naming a few of his successes. The collection will continue for a number of years and will total 10 coins, and who knows, perhaps a completer coin as well, if they follow the pattern of the Queen's Beast series from previous years. There's still plenty to look forward to this year though, with the Snowman and Snowdog 50p, 100 years of the BBC 50p, this year's Lunar Beast coins, the 25th anniversary of the bimetallic £2 collection, and Edward VII, which will round off this year's releases of the British Monarch series. And of course the Harry Potter collection, which my feathered friend reliably informs me is coming out fairly soon too, which we're really excited about. So let me know in the comments, what coin were you most excited about this month? What coins are you most excited about before the end of the year? Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel though, it means that you won't miss out on any of our future updates. If you hit that like button as well, it'll help the message get to more coin collectors out there too. You can also follow us on Facebook and Instagram, where we post lots of pictures of our coins. We're on Twitter and TikTok, we've got our shop and online store, but my co-host and I will see you next time for more amazing coins from the Britannia Coin Company.